is a scandal that's making headlines across the nation. Dozens indicted in an elaborate scheme to secure admission for students to prestigious universities.
Hollywood big shots, coaches, and parents now facing serious charges in connection to the scheme, including two Estonians, Niki Williams and Martin Fox. Channel 2's Investigates is digging deeper into their alleged roles in the scam. Our Brittany Jeffers has been following the trail of allegations against Williams. Brittany, what can you tell us?
Well, today we have been looking at that very extensive 200-page federal indictment, taking a closer look at the allegations against Niki Williams. Now, she is accused of taking thousands of dollars from parents all across the country who are trying to get better scores for their children on their ACT and SAT exams. Charged with conspiracy to commit racketeering and released on $20,000 bond, Channel 2 Investigates saw Niki Williams leaving federal court on Tuesday in a Ford pickup truck. But the allegations involve what prosecutors say happened inside of the classroom. College admittance test scores and athletics are at the center of the national scandal. The accused ringleader is William Rick Singer. The allegations show parents would pay Singer to secure their children's admission to elite schools like Stanford, Yale, and the University of Texas. For her part, Williams, an assistant teacher at a public school in Houston and an ACT administrator, is accused of accepting bribes. 5 pages of the indictment detail an elaborate plan where one of Singer's employees flew from Tampa to Houston to forge a test for a student in a hotel room. Using this handwriting sample, the indictment shows that Niki Williams, quote, was willing to do it and delivered and picked up the exam. Another example in the criminal complaint, a family lied to counselors in order to take the ACT at the Houston testing location. The student scored a 30 out of 36 after one of Singer's proctors, quote, discussed the answers during the exam. Documents show that Niki told the employee, quote, you know, these are out-of-state kids, essentially. There's nowhere anybody's going to know because in my books, it doesn't show where any money was paid. Even if she didn't know all the details of the national cheating scheme, our legal analyst Brian Weiss says any involvement can be a crime.
The problem with the conspiracy is you don't even have to know what your co-conspirators are doing to help share on the crime and help share on the time.
Now, Williams' next court appearance will be in Boston. In the meantime, coming up at 6, we'll have more from our legal analyst on the possible fallout and ramifications from all of this. Live in downtown Houston, I'm Brittany Jeffers, KPRC Channel 2 News.